Hi friends, we have successfully completed this lesson, the best investment I ever made by Dr. A.J. Cronin. So we have seen that the best investment, that was £7.10 on a man. Investment was on a man. Usually people invest, all investments is made on say factories or shares or LIC or bank or buying property or building, starting a shop, things like that. But here it is for the bringing back a young man, a smart young man, to bring him back into life. And then what has happened? The profit is not material gain or worldly gains, but the prophet is a good Samaritan. So the young man later on tend to be a good Samaritan. Now let's see the questions and answers. Today we will answer seven questions. The first seven questions. First question is, have you come across any person with importunate behavior? How did you deal and describe that? That is an open question, isn't it? So you can write, you can say no, then there's nothing more to be written. But if you say yes, you have to say, yes, I came across an importunate person and I was very kind to him. I heard everything what he said and I also fulfilled all his demands. You can write anything that you want. Why was the narrator not interested in the man who was watching him? Well, you know, the narrator wanted to take rest. So he did not like other people to interfere in his privacy, isn't it? That is, how did the narrator describe the man? You have seen he was of short build, clear blue eyes, he had rimless spectacles, his baldness just behind his forehead, then what else he had? And other things that has been described, the points here we have seen already. So that is the answer to that. What was the purpose of the voyager and his wife to America? That is for finding out, identifying maladjusted young men and young boys and young girls, adolescents, and then get them, take them to a place and also to put them on a track, you can say. So that is it. And the main purpose, the focus was to study ways and means, how to reform these people, how to redeem these people. I found myself liking him instinctively. Why? Next question, sixth question. Why? Because his sincerity was disarming. Sincerity was disarming. That means he in the beginning you can see that the doctor was unwilling to meet him or even look at him. He wanted to avoid him. But when he started speaking, he was impressed by his sincerity, his honesty and his enthusiasm. Great interest. Therefore, he instinctively liked him. What did Cronin learn about the man after questioning him further? After questioning him further, he came to know that this is not the first visit to America. This was not a holiday trip, sorry. Not a holiday trip, but it was for visiting people and things like that. I mean, especially young people. So what were they actually doing? They were, this redemption. Redemption means act of saving people. Now I have written all these answers here on the board. I will read out slowly so that I wish you write these answers. Of course, you will find the answers by some other people also. You can choose any. Not that I will have to learn my answers, but there are many people doing the same and the same lesson. So anyone. So one among the many answers. That's all. Okay. One option for you. Yes. So question number one. Have you come across? My answer is, you can take it from that. Importunate persons ask questions one after another. They are a cause of disturbance. Once I came into contact with such a person. I did not dislike him. I gave him a patient listening and answered his questions. So that's a positive way of approaching an importunate person. You can say, no, you go, I don't want to listen to you. That is not the way that we should do. Isn't it? Yes. Question, second question is, what was the narrator, why was the narrator not interested? The narrator wanted to take rest. He avoided the tedium of casual and importunate shipboard contacts. So he was not interested in the man who was watching him. Tedium means boredom. So he was not interested. He wanted to take rest and he wanted to avoid all the boredom. Third question is, how did the narrator describe the man? The narrator described the man thus. He was about 42 years old. He was short. He was fair. He had clear blue eyes. There was an onset of baldness just behind his forehead. He wore a dark suit. His tie was not very bright. His spectacles had no rims. He appeared to be serious and reserved. What is serious and reserved? He was not a person, importunate person. He was actually not very serious person. Not interested in simply getting into say gossip and things like that. Understand that? He did not want to waste time. He was a serious person. Okay. Now fourth question, what made the narrator notice the fellow voyager? On the next day also, the doctor's fellow voyager was watching him earnestly from his deck chair. So next day also, so that made what made the narrator notice? That made the narrator notice the fellow voyager the next day. Next day also, he saw him, he noticed that he was watching him. Fifth question. What is the purpose of the voyager and his wife to America? Their purpose was to study the methods used in dealing with cases of maladjusted, backward and delinquent young boys and girls. That was why they were visiting summer recreational camp clubs in New England states and settlement houses in New York. So that was about. That's a very important question. Question number 3 is a very good question. It can be asked as a short paragraph question. This also, fifth also, can be a short paragraph question also. And then sixth question, I found myself liking him instinctively. Why? The man was sincere and he had real interest in the work he was doing. His honesty and enthusiasm were charming and disarming. Charming, that's very attractive, and also very disarming. It's a charming girl or a charming woman, it's attractive. So his honesty was charming. That is, means he was very sincere. Not for, some people do this kind of work for showing others, or publicity. This was not for that. Seventh question, what did Cronin learn about the man after questioning him further? Dr. Cronin got a vivid picture of the work that the Johns were doing. Johns means Mr. John and Mrs. John. So he got a, when questioning further, he got this idea, the vivid picture of what they were doing. I think the questions are, answers are clear to you. So, very good. Take these answers down if you wish so. We'll continue with the next dose of questions and answers in the next class. Till then, bye. Have a nice day.